mañana, naya no sutaba, y le que se mina la mana mana, y bala bada bada bada, le suto cutulia de nada, y tiene el leo sutala y nada, y la mana mana, pablo suto cutulia, que da y prete que se le suti menia bada yaba, y la catalina naya no sute le meneme, y bala bada bada bada, every kid that presides to put it in this house. You know, we told people on Sunday, at our wedding service apart, everything that concerns to put them in this house, I am sure God will open ways for you. If God can make the barrenness of 11 years, 20 years to disappear, that is nothing they cannot do. Man, I declare that today your ways are open. Mark chapter 7. This is the word and prayer summit. So you don't need to think you see that for long. Mark chapter 7. If you're watching us online right now, make sure you are part of this and powerful. Write every word that comes out of my mouth by the grace of God, out of this place, write it online. And if you are here, claim it, write it out in your book and claim it in the name of Jesus. God is going to speak to someone tonight. Amen. And anyone that's word, yours, write it down. Mark chapter 7. I'm preaching on Ephata. Ephata. Mark chapter 7, 31 to 37. You can see that already starting to come up. Are we there? Mark chapter 7, 31. After, it's a word of prayer for me, so don't think I'm going to preach for long. We start up and pray. And again, departing from the coast of Tyre and Mist of the coast of Decapolis. Verse 32, can we verse 32 together? One, three, go. And they bring unto him one that was dead and had an impediment in his speech, and they beseech him to put his hand upon him. 33. And he took him aside from the multitude and put his finger into his ears and his feet and touched his tongue. 34. And looking up to heaven, he sighed and said unto him, Ephphatha, that is, be open. 35. And straightway, wait. Later. Let's read that verse 35. I'm not going to avoid. One to go. And straightway, yes, were open, and the speech of the tongue was used, and the spake plain. Or when Jagere, Latin, or Rayere, you Jagere. It means that your ways shall be open. Everything concerning your life shall be smooth. Somebody is not listening to me. What God is going to do for you tonight shall make your ways, your life to go smoothly. 36. And he charged them that they should tell no man. But the more he charged them, so the more he prayed it, they published it. Miracles that cannot be covered. Miracles that you will be making God. I told people to call me again. Miracles that will make people to call you. That will say we must call him to congratulate him. God will give to you. In the name of Jesus. Jesus said, don't tell anybody about this thing. But this man, you see, when something happens in your life, when the time you keep quiet, you say, I can't keep quiet. I can't keep quiet. Everyone that tends to keep quiet will look like an enemy.
Yeah.
No. I can't remember that. How can you tell a man who has not spoken, a boy who has not spoken for several years, and he has not, and a day, he's not going to say, you should keep quiet. How can he keep quiet? How does a baby behave when it's time to speak? He will just say anything. He cannot keep quiet. She cannot keep quiet. God will give me miracles that cannot keep quiet. Hear what I said. I didn't say you will not. I said miracles that cannot keep quiet.
Yes. Love miracles.
Hear this word very well. Miracles that cannot keep quiet. If your miracle did not keep quiet, how can you keep quiet? So I didn't tell you. I said this miracle by himself. The miracle by himself will not keep quiet. How can a woman that is pregnant keep quiet? The pregnancy is only speaking.
Two.
Say how many?
Two.
How many?
Two.
They bring to him one that was deaf. Chiefly, if you are deaf, that is the problem you do. Yeah. How can you not ask speech impediment again? You are deaf. The person cannot hear. And they say that he cannot speak very well. Imagine a boy of 45 years saying, ta-ta-ba-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. And you are not saying, what are you saying? It's not even hearing. Two problems upon one man. His issue was complicated by the devil. Every complicated issue tonight is made simple by God. It's not just made simple, it's solved by God. In the name of Jesus. One thing I like most was that they brought him to Jesus. For several years, they have not been breaking into Jesus. But one day, they remember, we have to take this guy to Jesus. One thing I like about you, you have brought everything about you to Jesus tonight. And I'm happy that you brought it to Jesus. One of my friends wrote on Facebook, he said, we go to church and we lay our body at the feet of Jesus. He said, but our problem is that when we are getting out of church, we also take the body out of the feet of Jesus. You do understand?
Yes.
You came to church. This is your body. Can I have the Bible? Can I have the Bible? How do you show something? Thank you. This is the body. I'm in church, Father. And I don't believe this body. I need Jesus. Jesus is your feet. Father, Father. Now we are seeing church service. And just when we pray, amen, in Jesus' name. Am I supposed to take this back? And not carry it back. I carry it home. Because of what? That's what worry does. When you are living at the feet of Jesus, let it be there. Only issues come up. They brought him to Jesus. Everything that concerns you, bring it to Jesus. Don't just be here physically. In your mind now, have a very great anticipation. And begin to gather everything in your mind because I'm going to pray very soon. Don't forget, see me, see miracle. That's why you are still going. See me, see miracle. Because that's what happened. They told top, he couldn't stop. He was saying, see me, see miracle. He's not there, but I knew that's what was happening. So they brought him to Jesus. I said, please, they were begging Jesus to heal. What was his assignment? What was his assignment?
To heal the sick.
Now, after 38, how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with Holy Ghost with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed. For God was with him. The assignment of Jesus, the Spirit of the Lord is upon him. For he anointed him to preach the gospel. Everything that was there is to bring the captive. He could do miracles and that was his mission. And God gave him a mission tonight to make sure that your life becomes better.
Amen.
So they were begging the miracle worker to do miracle. They don't need to beg him. He always does that. Allah bada bada bada. You don't need to beg him. Whenever you come to the presence of God, we explain to Joshua. You don't need to beg him. He said, where two or three are gathered? Have you forgotten that? Where two or three are gathered? I am dead in the room. God does not just appear in the midst of people without miracles. They were begging Jesus to do miracles. And verse 33. He took him aside from the multitude. To do something great, you need to move away from the multitude. What does it take Jesus to do the miracle among the multitude? He has done that several times. But in this one, he is a bringer of the multitude. He is teaching us a lesson that to do something great, you can't work with the multitude. But multitude will tell you, sister, are you still going to church? Are you still going to church today? No, you don't, I'm not supposed to go now. You know you prayed yesterday. The one you prayed yesterday, you have not gotten answer. So don't go. Even that woman that was in the midst of the woman with the issue of blood, she was in the midst of multitude. But when she was looking, she forgot the multitude. Yeah. She was going. Her mind was on Jesus, not on the multitude. So Jesus was doing something. He said, I'm going to take out of multitude. I'm going to take out of distraction. If you're going to do something in life, as right now, you are looking at me online, don't be distracted. Get out of the multitude. Multitude can be unbelief. It can be worries. It can be anything. It can be people that make the sense of multitude upon your life. That are looking at you and saying, what? He's praying. Nothing has happened, but God will surprise them tonight.
Amen.
He moved him out of the multitude. And I said, multitude can be distractions. What does it take Jesus to do miracle? He's the only Lord. He can tell them, shut up, I want to do miracle.
Yeah,
he can tell them, shut up, and you shut up. No, but they took the guy aside from the multitude. From the multitude, from distractions, from worries, from doubt, from fear, from everything that can make him not to be, not to concentrate. At times we come to church with, in worship, we are not concentrating. In message, we are not concentrating. For you to do something good in life, you need to get out of the money tree. Write it on life if you are there. To do something good in life, you need to get out of money tree. Money tree does not make this happen. Multitude does not make this happen. People of like minds make this happen, even if they are one or two. He puts his finger into his ear, the hand of God will touch you.
Amen.
At the right point of your lip, Jesus, look at the Bible, said the guy was deaf. So Jesus touched him at the point of deafness. Jesus will touch at the point of the virus. He will touch at the point of your poverty. He will touch at the point of your employment. In the name of Jesus. Whatever is your matter that concerns Jesus is pointing his finger to that place and saying, I am solving right now. Solution, solution, solution. In the name of Jesus. He went to the source of the problem.
Yes.
He went to the source. Lava, 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 lava. Because if this we solve, this we solve.
Yes.
Medically, if this solve, is that for this to solve? He went to the source. I'm going to, and he put his finger, don't forget, the finger of the Lord is a sign.
Yes.
The finger of the Lord does not touch a man, the man remains the same.
Yes.
A man can never remain the same when his finger of the Lord has touched him or her. Let's move to can pray. Let's move ahead. And his spirit. If I talk about spirit, not in this place. The DNA of the man, the best DNA of the man, is found in spirit. Look at me. You don't do DNA test. Sometimes blood can deceive.
Yes.
Something that does not deceive this. This spirit does not deceive. Yes. And that is mucus in your nose. Because you can never have my mucus, I can never have your mucus.
Yes.
Sometimes blood can deceive.
Yes.
So if I begin to tell you the mystery of speaking, when Jesus healed that man with blood bags, he said, what did he say? Is he like three? What did Jesus say? He speak on the ground. And Jesus was trying to say, let me give you my DNA. If I give my DNA, you're going to be healed. Lava, 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 lava. Because he speaking on the floor. He now mixing the sound. Because the sound was where the man came from. So lava, 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 lava. Nobody, he speaking on the floor. Oh, who was he there? Now they mixing with the origin of the man. His own DNA, meeting with his son, with the origin of the man. Then he put it in the eyes of the man. And the man said, I can see now. We're not going there today. I just gave this more. He speaks, because he was trying to say, Father, I'm giving my origin. I'm giving you my DNA, my DNA. He speaks, and touched his tongue. He touched his tongue. The hand of God touched the DNA of the man. You see, he touched the ear, number one. Out of that day, the man began to hear. From today, your ears will begin to hear good news.
Yeah.
Everything that is bad news,
yes.
I stop them happening to you.
Yeah.
Not here. I stop bad news coming to you.
Yeah.
You are lying. I stop bad news coming to you.
Yeah.
I stop bad news coming to you.
Yeah.
On sight and on light, I stop bad news coming to you.
Yeah.
Touch his tongues. Right from there, you begin to speak well.
Amen.
The man was speaking lava, he's not speaking in tongue. Don't consider speaking in tongue. Okay, when I'm speaking in tongue, Jesus will not touch his tongue. So don't make mistakes. He was saying, I am. But Jesus touched, after Jesus touched his tongue, lava, his language changed. God is changing your language.
Amen.
Stand up, he's changing your language.
Amen.
Like the language will change from today.
Amen.
Sometimes poverty has so much overridden some people, and the language has become language of poverty.
Yes.
That if they cannot buy up to $1 for their friend, they say they don't have money.
Yes.
May poverty not override you.
Amen.
May poverty not override you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May poverty not override you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But if I tell you of that, God is speaking is poverty. When you want to buy clothes, they buy 2,000, what you want to? But you still 2,000, you know? 2,000 per year is costly for you. Now, who wants it to be like that, too? 2,000 per year is costly for you. What kind of money? Your language is changing. God that gave my friend. to check whether it is fine. That broke barriers of 11 years in their life. We give you miracles that people will gather to celebrate you. We give you name ceremony and we're more than 67 on Zoom. What if you now gather physically from all over the world? The pastor said, this is a very special baby. That people are celebrating all over the world. Because there are people from Taiwan, people from South Africa, to celebrate us in one baby. That's the kind of miracle God does. What God will do for you, the whole earth will celebrate you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
From now you are blessed.
Amen.
Your blessing remains.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
Whoever calls you is doing himself.
Amen.
Whoever calls you is doing himself.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your blessing shall remain forever.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we are.